we've seen a lot of content kind of revolving around this month and the sport of lacrosse. Do you think it's been enough? Do you think it has worked? Do you actually feel the support? You know, is it there, or do you think there's still some ways to go?
Yeah, there's still a lot that needs to be done, right? I mean, it's a good step in the right direction because we're finally getting the acknowledgement, right? And on a consistent basis. I don't think that happens, you know, unless it was so overwhelmingly true. You consider, you know, what Zed Williams has done this summer. You know, you consider what Lyle Thompson has been doing for a very long time. Randy Stotts, you know, Adam Bomberry is one of the best defensemen in the NLL. You know, Warren Hill. You know, Dougie Jamison, I can go on forever. And from top to bottom, you know, professional to club level, everywhere you look is a good young native man who is very good at lacrosse and represents the game the right way. Maybe, you know, all the attention and all the homage that's being paid to our roots, you know, maybe that is a product of, you know, it just being so undeniable, you know, which is okay, you know, whatever, you know, if that's how we got to do it, then that's fine. As we become more empowered by the lacrosse community, you know, I think, you know, we're going to be more and more willing to, you know, confront and address publicly. You know what I mean? I don't think we're having this conversation unless, you know, we're getting the support that we have been getting, you know, throughout, you know, the last 6 or 7 months, right?
Well, you mentioned that you don't think the right questions are being asked. So I want to ask you, what is a question that you wish was asked more?
I think the facts that are most impactful are the ones that, you know, you kind of shy away from, or at least I do. I never want to see myself as a victim of my circumstances, right? You know, growing up on a reservation, you know, playing Division I lacrosse. I talked about this just a little bit ago, you know, what it's like to walk the halls of a high school being native. You know what I mean? 100 goods are undone by one bad for a lot of kids, you know, and that's just the facts, right? Because there's that instant jump to, oh yeah, just another native kid, right? I think if you're going to get to the heart of, you know, some of the circumstances we face, you got to make it geared towards our youth. What about the way you were perceived growing up, or, you know, throughout your lacrosse career, do you want to be different for kids now? That is a major point of why, you know, a lot of us play the game. Who we are as people, right? Our religion, you know, or spirituality, whatever you want to call it, it's all about a stream of consciousness. Right? It's all about your place and the world around you. You know, we learn life through experiences. You know what I mean? Like that is the focal point of our identity and the space we occupy on this earth. Circling back, you know, every time, you know, I put on the jersey, you know, or I pick up a stick, you know, I feel the energy of that kid that fell in love with the game. You know, but like residential schools, you know, and in the States, what do they call them? They call them tribal boarding schools. Those things were open till the 70s and 80s. Those are places where kids were literally taken from their homes and forced to assimilate. And if they didn't, they were beaten, they were molested. You know, these are real fucking things. Sorry for swearing
That's
again.
okay.
You know, imagine having that trauma in your life. There are people who, in my community, who have been forcefully removed from their traditional lands. You know, Army Corps engineers came in, burned all their houses, put a dam up, and fucking flooded their lands. That same person, you know, maybe had, you know, a sibling, you know, that was taken from their family growing up. You know, and put into one of these schools and stripped of everything they should know, everything they know about themselves, and then put back on the reservation, you know, to like a termination policy, you know, Like, how do you think that impacts a person's ability to live in this world, to raise kids? There's just a lot of, pain in our communities. And you don't understand what this medicine is until, you know, you've been a little kid who's never seen your grandma smile or your grandpa smile. But that time he's in the backyard with you teaching you how to play. And that time, you know, you're on the field and you're scoring. And you can see, like, this is all real things, you know?
Mm-hmm.
If you could find a way to get to the root of all of those kind of things, you know, they're deeply personal. I think once you get at the heart of, you know, why we play it today and what it means for us today, and you start pushing that out, that's when people will really understand, you know, really start to understand.
When we were talking about this interview before, you said that you didn't want to, you know, come on here and tell the creator story. But I think you just said it perfectly. Like, mm-hmm. I think what's been missing is people are looking at the beauty of it, which is great, but also by doing that, kind of overlooking the pain behind that. Is that correct to say?
Absolutely. Because that's already out there enough.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm not saying
that. Do you like it? Do you approve of that story kind of making the rounds and people learning about it?
So think about this. The game of lacrosse is given to our people as an alternative to war. If you look at human history, it's all about dominance. It's all about conquering. It's all about erasing foes. You know what I mean? It's like, and we settled on a mode where nobody, like, it wasn't about killing people, you know? You settle, like, our conflict resolution was a lacrosse game. Like, think about that. Think about the ideologies that go behind constructing, like, that as a part of your society, you know? So, I mean, I love that. I love the history of lacrosse. Lacrosse is kind of reemerging in my community, you know? I think Onondaga and Six Nations have carried on the tradition throughout, you know, but there was a period where, you know, all of our boys played baseball, you know, and football, you know, and that's a testament to the termination policy, termination era in the United States, right? Everyone was sent off to boarding schools, you know, everyone, you know, had to have their, you know, their hair cut, you know, be able to read, educated, you know, go to work on the railroad, play football, baseball, you know what I mean? American pastimes. Like, there was a serious attempt, you know, by federal governments in Canada and the United States to make our people just like them. Because without your tradition, without your religion, without your language, you don't have an identity, you know? And that was like the whole point. Brendan Bomberry and Randy Stotts, they have their Turtle Island Lacrosse. And their Instagram account has been really good throughout the month with releasing content. That is, you know, it's really valuable and precise when it comes to understanding, you know, the state of our communities today, relationships between, you know, our tribes and the local governments, you know, and I think, you know, they just do a good job of really, you know, not putting too much in your face, but just enough to make you actually get something from it.